How do Spider-Man's new lenses work? Let's take a look at this. Science behind Spider-Man. Spider-Man Homecoming has been a long time, well, coming. Every geek out there remembers February of 2015, when Marvel Studios and Sony announced that a new version of Spider-Man would be coming to the MCU. And now, here we are, more than 2 years later, about to get the first ever Spider-Man movie to connect to other large Marvel superheroes like Iron Man and Captain America. I mean, there is the fact that they're making a Venom movie that is in the MCU. And that they're doing a Silver Sable and Black Cat movie. And Mysterio. And Kraven. But let's ignore that mess that is the movie Spider-Verse. Let's focus on the subject of this video, Spider-Man's new suit. A lot of people have their own opinions on the design of Spidey's new suit. The big difference it has with all the other Spider-Man suits in movie history is the AI and technology implemented into it. It's sort of like Iron Man armor without actually being armor. One of the coolest things about it, aside from the classic web wings and the overall look of it, is the eyes. Spidey's always had a rugged gag with his expressive eyes, but of course, that itself seems impossible. Even a year ago, the Deadpool movie didn't bother to explain how his mask did it. Not that that was an issue, it made for good comedy. But the MCU's story on this is a little different. Spider-Man's suit involves a lot of tech. What we know about his eyes on the surface is that they look to work like camera shutters, and simply narrow or widen depending on what Spider-Man's real eyelids are doing. But how does this work? What is the technology behind Spider-Man's expressive lenses? Well, there's a few ways this could work. However, I think we can all agree that it probably works off of a motion sensor. Otherwise, they'd have to be attached to his eyelids, and I can only imagine how uncomfortable that would be. So, a motion sensor is probably involved in Spider-Man's lenses, but that covers a wide range. There are lots of different types of motion sensors, and we need to know what all of them are before we go choosing one of them. There are passive infrared sensors, which detect levels of body heat. Microwave sensors send out microwave energy pulses that reflect off of moving objects, similar to echolocation. Area reflective type sensors use LED lights to send out infrared waves that will measure the distance the sensor is from a moving object it detects. Ultrasonic sensors use sound to locate moving objects, which is literally echolocation. And finally, vibration sensors detect vibrations from a given area and are the easiest of all the sensors to make. As it seems with that list, there's only one sensor that could really fit our criteria, and that's the vibration sensor. These sensors would be able to easily detect Spider-Man's eyelid movement without actually damaging his eyes. To know how vibration sensors could work for Spider-Man's lenses, we first need to know how they work in the first place. Vibration sensors work off of something called the piezoelectric effect. The piezoelectric effect was first discovered in 1880 by French physicist brothers Pierre and Jacques Curie. The piezoelectric effect, in basic terms, happens when pressure on an object is translated by that object into electrical energy. Specifically, there are many materials that are subject to the piezoelectric effect, like salt and quartz. Knowing that, it isn't hard to picture Spider-Man's lenses working off of the piezoelectric effect. Think of it as having two pairs of piezoelectric sensors, one for the vibrations caused by his eyelids hitting the tops and bottom of his eyes, thereby widening the lenses, and one for reading smaller vibrations caused by his downward eyelid movement or his eyes closing and narrowing the lenses. Now, on paper, that might just sound perfect. However, we run into tons of issues with this. Sensors alone just might not be enough to really get these lenses to work properly. Being Spider-Man constitutes a lot of vibration, from swinging fast through the air to standing near explosions at an airport. Spidey's around massive vibrations all the time. Ultimately, a contraption this basic would work in theory, but not in practice. The vibrations around him would just send them off and on constantly, and render them pretty much useless. So, if a vibration sensor, or any of the other sensors for that matter, aren't likely candidates, then what is? Well, hold on to your horses. Vibration sensors may still be involved in Spidey's suit. They may just be more complex. As weird, or maybe as fitting as it sounds, Spider-Man's suit may very well work off of VR. Here, let me explain. There's a lot of components that go into creating VR. VR is all about creating a virtual yet interactive environment for the subject. One of the most important parts of this is sight. You need to see the environment around you for it to be VR, right? When you're wearing a headset for VR, there's lots of things at work to ensure that happens. One of the things VR keeps track of is movement, for when you're looking around or even just walking. VR does this by using an accelerometer. An accelerometer, in this case, uses motion sensing technology to recreate real movement virtually. For instance, if you begin to move your head in VR, the accelerometer will understand that you're picking up speed and will move the environment accordingly. If you continue to pick up speed, it will do the same. If you remain at a constant speed, so will the accelerometer. And if you slow down or stop, the accelerometer will still do the same. It's all about translating one movement into another. But one of the most interesting things about this translation is that it uses a very specific, microscopic motion sensor that relies on the piezoelectric effect to copy movement. If we were to put a similar accelerometer into Spider-Man's suit, it could actually work. The microscopic vibration sensor would actually be able to accurately pick up Spidey's eyelid movement and directly copy the movement into his lenses, making their movement foolproof, accurate, and reliable. And that's one way Spider-Man's moving lenses could work in real life. As it turns out, a lot of things about Spider-Man aren't really that far off from real life. Everything from his powers to his expressive lenses has some root, sometimes a lot of root, in reality. In fact, there's a lot of people who have already built their own expressive lenses. Among spectacular, amazing, and many other things, it looks like Spider-Man has stayed sensational.